we're starting on our concert today. We are live in 5, 4, 3. Please give it up for the radio on the air, advertisement for our travel agency, 8th grade choir.
Thank you.
If you're going to help George, you need to know a little about him.
See the town over there?
Yes, a group of boys playing down a snow-covered hill onto the ice. Yippee! Who's that?
That's George Bailey. Way back when he was 12, in 1975, something happened to you need to remember for later on.
Here comes my scaredy cat little brother, Harry.
I'm not scared.
Oh no! Harry! Help! Harry's falling through the ice!
I'm coming, Harry!
George was able to save his brother, but the icy water gave George a bad year. It was weeks before he could return to his after-school job at Mrs. Gower's pharmacy and ice cream shop.
Thank you.
I would have not been able to stay focused.
It's me, Miss Gallagher. George Bailey.
You are late.
$2 worth of toppings.
Please, George. Oh, please. You like every boy.
Here you go.
Bye, George.
Made up your mind yet, Mary?
I'll take chocolate.
With coconut?
I don't like coconut.
What? You don't like coconut? Do you have any idea where it comes from? Tahiti? Fiji Islands? The Coral Sea? I've been nominated for a membership in the National Geographic Society, you know. I'll get yours.
Oh, George Bailey, I'll love you till the day I die.
I'll spoil the world, just you wait.
Goodbye, George.
Goodbye, Mary. What was that piece of paper George just picked up?
It's a letter from Mrs. Gower. She received some tragic family news this morning.
Miss Gower, do you need anything?
Just take this medicine over to Mrs. Williams.
Ma'am. Miss Gower, something's wrong with this prescription.
Excuse me? Do you know who you're talking to? Get out of here!
But Miss Gower, you know what you're doing. You're giving me the wrong prescription. Poison.
Oh, George.
All I wanted to do was make sure, Miss Gower. I won't tell again. And did he keep it a secret?
He sure did.
Did he ever marry that sweet little Mary? Did he ever go exploring?
We'll get there soon enough. George grew up and wanted to go to college, but there just wasn't enough money. So he worked for 4 years at the Building and Loan Association.
The what?
His father owned the building and loan business, along with George's Uncle Billy.
George, what's the combination to the safe?
We wrote it down so you wouldn't forget it.
That's right. Where?
Who is that?
That's Henry F. Potter, the meanest and richest man in all the country.
Peter, Potter's here.
Mr. Bailey, Mr. Bailey, there's nothing quite so lonesome as a family business. Now, Peter, you know what I'm here for. I'm on a very tight schedule. Families are victim three.
Okay, then, Potter, here's the thing. I just need a little more time. I'll dig up that money somehow.
Have you put any pressure on those people of yours to pay their mortgage?
Times are hard, Mr. Potter. There's a lot of people out of work.
Then foreclose.
I can't do that. These families have children.
Are you running a business or a charity?
Mr. Potter, have some compassion.
Do not ask me to overlook your failures.
Do not call my father a failure.
What kind of business are you running here?
George worked and saved enough to get to college, but before he went to college, he decided to go to Europe and explore. Mrs. Gower surprised him with a gift of a suitcase. On his way home from the pharmacy, he ran into some of his friends, Ernie, the cab driver, and Bert, the cop.
Hey, Ernie.
Hi, George.
Hey, Bert.
Hey, George, what's the suitcase for?
I'm a rich tourist today. How about driving me home in style? Oh, hi, Violet. I like your dress.
Oh, this little thing? Why, I only wear it when I don't care how I look.
Want to come on, Bert?
No, thanks. I'll go see what the family's doing.
Family man.
That evening, George had dinner with his father.
My last supper here. I can't believe it.
We're sure going to miss you. I wish we could send Harry to college with you.
We have that all figured out. Harry will take my job at the building and loan for 4 years, and then he'll go to college.
It's just a help. But wouldn't you consider coming back to the building and loan? Would you?
Oh, I couldn't face being cooped up for the rest of my life in that office. I'm sorry, Pop. I didn't mean that negatively. But the business of spending your life trying to figure out how to save money, I'd go crazy. I want to do something big, important.
You know, George, I feel that in a small way we're doing something important. It's not too much for a man to want his own room. And we're helping him to get that in our little office.
most of my friends have already finished college. I just feel like if I don't get away, I'll bust.
You're right, son. This town's no place to live if you're not willing to crawl the pot. Get your education and get out of here.
Thanks, Pop. Say, maybe I'll go say goodbye to Main Street. Last night in town and all.
Alright, you have a nice time, son.
Hi, Georgie!
Hi, Vi.
Where are you going?
I'll probably end up at the library.
Don't you ever get tired about reading that about them things?
Not really. What are you up to?
Not a thing, Georgie.
I really can't stay.
But baby, it's cold outside.
I've got to go away.
But baby, it's cold outside.
This evening has been
hoping that you dropped
so
in.
Very nice.
I'll hold your hands, they're just like us.
My mother will start to work.
Beautiful, what's your hurry?
My father will be pacing the floor.
Listen to the fireplace roar.
So really, I'd better skirt.
Beautiful, please don't hurry.
The neighbors, oh shoot. Neighbors, my thing.
What's that out there?
Say, what's in this drink?
How's we had out there?
I wish I knew how to break the spell.
I'll hold your hat. Your hair looks
rough. I ought to say no, 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 sir.
Mind if I move in a little bit?
At least I'm gonna say that I tried.
What's the sense of hurt in my pride?
I really can't stay.
Baby, it's cold.
Ah, but it's cold outside. I simply must go.
Baby, it's cold outside.
The answer is no.
Baby, it's cold outside.
Your welcome has been
hoping that you dropped in.
Nice and warm.
Look out the window at that storm.
The winter will be.
Got your lips look delicious.
My brother will be there at the door.
Waves upon a tropical shore.
My aunt's mind is vicious.
Got your lips are
but
delicious.
But maybe just a cigarette more.
Never such a loser.
I gotta get
but
home.
Baby, you'll freeze out there.
Say, lend me a
it's
coat.
It's up to my knees out.
You've really been
I
grand.
Really
but don't you see?
How can you do this thing to me?
There's bound to be talk tomorrow.
Think of your lifelong sorrow.
At least there will be plenty in love.
If I got no and I
really can't
get
stay.
Over that cold.
All of it is cold. Baby, it's cold outside. Let's go on an adventure.
Oh, I'd love it. What should we do?
Let's go out in the field, take our shoes off, and walk in the grass. Then we can go to the lake and swim, climb Mount Bedford, and watch the sun.
Have you gone crazy? Walk in the grass in my bare feet and climb up the mountain? Oh my, no.
Okay, just forget about the whole thing. Well, hee-haw, George. Forget what? Oh, nothing, Sam. Well, you remember Mary, don't you? Of course. Well, you wouldn't mind walking her home, would you?
Of course not.
All right.
George walked Mary home. Is that important?
I'd say it is, because even though Mary lived only 4 blocks away, it took them 2 hours to get there.
You know something? If it wasn't me talking, I'd say you're the prettiest girl in town.
Well, why don't you say it?
Maybe I will. Oh, look where we are.
Oh, the old Granville house.
Do you know about observable houses? You make a wish and I throw a rock.
Oh, don't, George. I love this place. I wish I lived here.
I wouldn't live there if I was a ghost. Watch this. Pretty good shot, huh?
What's your wish?
Not a wish. A whole heart full of wishes. I'm shaking the dust off this crummy town off my feet, and I'm going to see the world. Then, I'm coming back here to go to college. Then I want to build the tallest buildings. Are you going to throw a rock, too? Nice. What did you wish for?
If I tell you, it won't come true.
What do you want? The moon? All you gotta do is just say the word. I'll throw a lasso around it and pull it down.
Okay, I'll take it. And then what?
And then...
Oh, stop talking. Your ear off.
Who's that?
It's Mr. Collins on his porch.
You just wasted on the young.
George, you have to get in the car. Your father, he's had a stroke.
I'm sorry, Mary. I've got to go.
His father died that night, Clarence. George didn't go to Europe.
Discuss this.
His faith and devotion are responsible for this organization.
Peter Bailey was not a businessman. He was a man of high ideals without common sense. And what does that get us, I want to say?
Just a minute, Mr. Potter. You're right when you say my father was no businessman. Why he ever started this business, I'll never know. But you can't say anything about his character. He never once thought of himself. But he did help a few people get out of your slums, Mr. Potter. People were human beings to him, but to you, a more frustrated old man, they're cattle. In my book, he died a richer man than you'll ever be.
I'm not interested in your book.
You're the board. Do what you want. But remember that this town needs one institution where people don't have to crawl to power.
I want my motion carried.
What happened, George? All we heard was yelling.
Oh boy, Matilda. You should have heard George.
Yeah, they're trying to close us in there.
They voted Potter down. We're open for business. But under one condition, that you take your father's place, George.
I'm going to college. Uncle Billy's your man.
It's you or we're closed.
So, George didn't go to college.
That's right, Clarence. He gave his college money to his brother instead and waited for years for Harry to come back and take over the business. Then he could see the world.
Here she is. Meet my wife.
Wow. Congratulations. Why don't you tell us? What's a pretty girl like you marrying this two-headed brother of mine?
It was purely out of pity. I promise. My father offered him a job.
A job?
George, about the job. I never said I'd take it. You've been here waiting, and I won't let you down. Let's go home.
George.
Hello, Mother.
I like her. It seems like she'll keep Harry on his toes.
And down at Bedford Falls.
George, do you know that Mary Hatch is back in school? Nice girl, Mary. The kind who will help you find all the answers.
Sure.
Now, give me one good reason why you shouldn't call her.
Sam's crazy about her.
Well, she's not crazy about him. Besides, Sam's in New York. You're in Bedford Falls.
How do you know that?
I'm a mother. I have my ways.
All right, my girl, all right. I'll go stop by your house.
That's right. Have fun, George. Hello, George. Your mother phoned to say you'd be coming over. Would you like to come in?
No, I was just passing by, but since I'm here, sure. Say, Mary, I thought you'd go back to New York with the rest of the gang.
Oh, no, I was too homesick.
For here?
Yes, for my family and everything.
Well, I still can't understand it. I really didn't tell anyone.
Would you rather leave?
No, I don't want to be rude.
It's so nice about Harry and Ruth.
Just as well.
Don't you like her? Or is it just the marriage you're not so enthusiastic about?
No, I like her. And marriage is okay for Harry and Sam and you.
Mary, who are you talking to?
It's George Bailey, Mother.
George? What does he want?
I don't know. What do you want, George?
Not a thing. I just came in to get warm.
You go home. Sam promised to call from New York tonight, didn't he?
What did you come here for?
I was told you were the one with the answers. You tell me.
Oh, why don't you go home?
That's where I'm going.
Oh, hello, Sam. How are you?
Great, it's good to see you, to hear your voice again.
That's sweet of you, Sam. I have an old friend of yours, George Bailey's here.
George, put him on the phone.
George, Sam would like to speak with you.
Hi, Sam.
What you doing, pal? Trying to steal my girl?
I'm not trying to steal your girl.
I want to talk to the both of you. Put me on speaker.
We're listening, Sam.
I've got a big deal coming up that's going to make us all rich. George, remember that night at Morgan's restaurant when you told me about making plastics out of soybeans?
I do.
My father's checked into it and wants to build us a factory outside of Rochester. How do you like that?
Why not here in Bedford Falls? Half the town's out of work.
Is that so? Then it's settled. Now here's the point, George. I may have a job for you. And, oh, Mary!
Yes?
Tell him this is a chance of a lifetime.
He says it's a chance of a lifetime.
Give me that phone.
Excuse me.
Now, listen to me. Mary, I don't want any plastics, and I don't want any job, and I don't want to get married, ever, to anyone. Do you understand that? I want to do what I want to do. And you're...
I stand
George and Mary were married, and following the wedding, George's pal Ernie drove the couple to the train station.
Were you two off on this honeymoon?
We're going everywhere. A whole week in New York, then Bermuda. The best hotels, the oldest champagne, the richest caviar, the newest music, and the prettiest wife. Then what, honey?
After that, who cares?
Hey, George, there's something funny going on at the building and loan. See, it looks like a vine.
Pull over a minute, will you, Ernie? What is this, Uncle Billy? Why are the doors locked? What's happened?
The bank's called, and they took all our money, every last cent.
What?
And then everybody started coming outside. I got scared.
Open the doors. Let them in.
Where's our money, George?
The money's not here. It's in people's houses. Now, what are you going to do? Foreclose them?
I have $242 here. That isn't going to break anybody.
All right, Charlie, you'll get your money in 60 days.
60 days?
That's what you agreed to when you bought your shares.
I got money. Potter's taking over the bank. He'll pay you 50 cents on every dollar.
If Potter gets a hold of your shares, he'll own the building and loan. He's got the bank, he's got the bus line, and everything else in town. And now he's after us because he wants all the power and control. We can get through this, okay? We just have to find faith in each other.
My husband's out of work. We need money.
How much do you need? We have $2,000 from the wedding.
That will tide us over until the bank reopens. All right, Charlie, how much do you need?
$242.
Aw, Charlie, just enough to tide you over.
I'll take $242.
Fine. Eva, how much do you get by?
$20, I suppose.
Now we're talking, Mrs. Thompson.
Could I have $17.50?
Oh, bless your heart, of course you can. Pay it back when you can. Okay, who's next?
Look at the clock.
5, 4, 3, 2, we made it. Lock that door, Uncle Billy. We're still in business.
Building it. Just a minute. George, there's a call for you. It's Mrs. Bailey.
Oh, I don't want to talk to Mrs. Bailey. I want to talk to my wife. Oh, Mrs. Bailey, that's my wife, Mary. Hello, listen, I'm sorry, what? Come home? What home? 320 Sycamore, whose home is that? Okay.
Whose house is it?
You see, 320 Sycamore was the old Granville house, the one George and Mary threw rocks at and made wishes. Mary had prepared the house and made a fantastic meal. It became their new home.
Welcome home, Mr. Bailey.
Well, I'll be.
Remember the night we broke the windows? This is what I wish for.
You're wonderful.
And that's where they started their lives together. Mary made the leaky old house a home while George worked away at the building and loan office.
Oh, Mary, why in the world would you ever marry a guy like me anyway?
To keep from being an old maid.
I was going to give you the moon, but what have I given you? You could have married Sam or anybody else in town.
I didn't want to marry anybody else in town. Besides, I want my child to look like you.
You didn't even have a honeymoon. I promised you. You what?
My child.
You mean Mary? You're on the nest?
George Bailey last was the stork.
Stars are brightly shining. It is the night.
Fighting to keep the building and loan open.
We're getting close to present time, aren't we?
Yes, Clarence. You know almost everything you need to know now, except what happens that finds him discouraged. Today is the week before Christmas, and Billy's at the bank to make a deposit when he runs into Potter.
Well, well, well. Mr. Potter, come to the bank to deposit some more loot? How do you like the news on the paper, Mr. Potter? Let's see. Harry Bailey wins Congressional Medal of Honor.
Let me see that paper.
Here you go. Go on and keep it. I'm off to make a deposit.
Good morning, Mr. Potter.
Good morning, Hope. Here you are. Deposit slip and all.
What about the money in the deposit slip?
That's right. Money. Money. Where's the money?
A terrible thing, Clarence. Uncle Billy couldn't find the money because the envelope with the $8,000 was folded in the newspaper he gave to Mr. Potter.
Looks like his son should join him, George. I wonder if he's off to marry somewhere. Shouldn't George report for work or something?
What's the matter, Uncle Billy?
The boy's getting a pay deduction.
Oh, here he is. Off in the sunset.
George!
What's the matter, Uncle Billy?
The money! I don't know what happened to it.
What? Where is it? I told you to put it in your coat pocket.
Oh, I'm no good to you, George. I'm no good.
Uncle Billy, we've got to find that money. Think.
I can't think anymore. It hurts.
Where's that money, you silly old fool? Do you realize what this means? It means bankruptcy and scandal and prison. One of us is going to jail. Well, it's not going to be me.
And so George ran to his house, faster than it took him to get on for his entrance. Just as the first snow of the season began to fall.
What happened to him?
Well, Clarence, the end of the story is up to us.
Thank you.
Where's your coat and hat?
I left them at the office.
Isn't it wonderful about Harry? We're famous, George. I bet I had 50 calls today about the parade and the banquet.
Must she keep playing that?
Mommy says we can stay up till midnight practicing Christmas carols.
Better hurry and get ready. The families will be here soon.
Families? I don't want the families over here.
Excuse me. Have a hectic day?
Oh yeah, another big red letter day for the Baileys.
Daddy, the Browns next door have a new car. You should see it.
Well, what's the matter with our car? Isn't it good enough for you?
Excuse me. Excuse me.
Excuse you for what?
Ever.
All right, darling, you're excused. Now go upstairs and see what Zuzu wants.
What's the matter with Zuzu?
Oh, she caught a cold coming home from school. They gave her a flower and she didn't want to crush it, so she didn't button up her coat. The doctor says it's nothing serious.
Is she running a temperature?
Just a little one.
It's this old house. I don't know why we don't have pneumonia, I guess, but this drafty old place might as well be living in a refrigerator. Why do we have to live here in the first place and just stay around this crummy old town?
George, what's wrong?
Everything's wrong. You call this a happy family? Why do we have to have all these kids?
Dad, how do you spell frankincense?
I don't know. Ask your mother.
Where are you going?
Up to see Zuzu.
Hi, Daddy.
What happened to you?
I want a flower.
It's a beauty, Zoo.
Some of the petals came off. Paste it.
All right, now. Good as new. Now you try to get some sleep.
I'm not sleepy. I want to look at my flower.
I know, but you just go to sleep, and then you can dream about it. It'll be a whole garden.
It will?
Uh-huh.
Telephone.
I'll get it. Hello? Yes, this is Mrs. Bailey. Oh, thank you, Mrs. Welch. The doctor says she'll be out of bed by the time for Christmas dinner.
Is that Zuzu's teacher?
Yes.
Let me speak to her. Hello, Mrs. Welch? This is George Bailey. Say, what kind of teacher are you anyway? What do you mean sending her home without her coat zipped?
George.
Is this the sort of thing we pay taxes for? To have teachers like you, silly, careless people who send our kids home unprepared for the winter? Oh, that's silly.
Hello, Mrs. Welch. I want to apologize for it. She hung up.
Daddy, how do you spell hallelujah?
What do you think I am, a dictionary? Janie, haven't you learned that silly tune yet? You've played it over and over again. Now stop it. Stop it.
George, what are you doing?
I'm sorry, Mary. Janie, I didn't mean... You go on and practice. Pete, I owe an apology too. What did you want to know? What's the matter with everybody? Janie, go on. I told you to practice. Go on, play.
George, why must you torture the children? Why don't you...
Mary...
Is yeah. Daddy in trouble?
Yes, Pete.
Shall I pray for him?
Yes, pray for him very hard.
Me too?
You too, Tommy. Hello, Uncle Billy.
So that's it, George? Short 8,000?
Any sort of interest, Mr. Potter, if you still want the building alone.
You say it was lost. Did you notify the police?
No, I haven't. With Harry's homecoming tomorrow.
Why come to me? Why don't I go to Sam?
I can't get a hold of him. He's in Europe.
What kind of security do you have, George?
I have a 15,000 life insurance policy.
How much is your equity in it?
$500.
And you won 8,000? You used to be so confident. You were going to go out and conquer the world. You once called me a warped, frustrated old man. What are you but a warped, frustrated young man? You're probably in here asking for help.
Do anything, Mr. Potter, please.
You know what I'm going to do for you? As a stockholder of the building and loan, I'm calling the state examiner to get a warrant for your arrest. Misappropriation of funds, manipulation.
Because I'm your guardian angel.
Perfect.
Now I know you're upset about the $8,000.
You know about that.
I'm your guardian angel.
Well, you look about the kind of angel I get. Sort of a fallen angel. What happened to your wings?
I haven't earned my wings yet. That's why I'm second class. But you can help me earn them by helping you.
You don't happen to have 8,000 bucks, do you?
Now, I won't get my wings with that attitude. You just don't realize all you've done. If it hadn't been for you...
Oh, Clarence, stop. I just wish that I'd never lived here.
What did you say?
I said I wish I'd never lived here.
Oh, George, you've given me an idea. That'd do it, okay? There. You've got your wish. You've never lived here.
What? You've never lived here?
Exactly. No worries at all and no problems to solve.
Wait a minute. I can hear in this ear.
That's right, don't you see?
Well, if it's not the...
Well, let's head back to mornings. You'll walk and I'll fly.
Here's a table. Welcome to the best restaurant in Bedford Falls.
Bedford Falls? Don't you mean Pottersville?
Pottersville? Hey, where's Morgan, your boss?
Look, I'm the boss. Do you want to eat or not?
Okay, yes. I'll have a hamburger.
Make that two.
What is it about this place? It seems to have changed.
All of Bedford Falls has changed. You're having your wish, George. There will be lots of things you've never seen. Oh, good! Somebody's just made it. Every time you hear a bell rings, it means that angel just got their wings.
What did you say?
Don't mind him, Nick. He never grew up. How old are you anyway, Clarence?
293 next May.
That does it. Out, you two. Out! Well, look who showed up. Didn't I tell you to never show up here again?
Hey, it's Mrs. Gallagher.
I just need some food, Nikki. Please.
Sky, please show Mrs. Gower to the door.
You got it.
Nikki, why are you throwing her out?
Mrs. Gower? She spent 20 years in jail for filling a bad prescription. If you know her, you can't be a good person yourself. Sky, here's two more. Please show them to the door.
Absolutely.
George, Mrs. Gower doesn't know you. You weren't there to stop her from switching the prescription.
What do you mean I wasn't there? Why is this all happening?
It's because you've never lived here. You've been giving a great gift, George. Now you can see what the town would be like if you hadn't lived here.
You're crazy, and you're driving me crazy, too. Now, leave me a home. I'm going to my wife.
Grace, I'm not sure if I'm helping you or making things worse. What should I do?
Clarence, remember that the spirit of the holidays. Music can lift your spirits and inspire all who are lucky enough to hear you. Give it a try.
This is called karma.
Look at that. Like, that's kind of there.
Maybe it's much too early in the game. Ah, but I thought I'd ask you just the same. What are you doing New Year's Eve?
Who's gonna be the one to hold you tight when it's exactly 12 o'clock at night? Welcome.
Maybe I'm crazy to suppose I'd ever be the one you chose.
How do you know my family?
Ernie, I've been to your house 1,000 times.
What's the idea? I lived in Potter's Field with my wife, left 3 years ago, and I've never seen you before in my life.
Okay, just step on it. Get me home.
Is this the place?
Of course it's the place.
It hasn't been lived in for over 20 years.
Mary, Pete, Tommy, Jamie, Zuzu, I'm home.
They're not here, George.
What have you done with them?
One man's life touches so many others. When he isn't around, he lives a pretty good boy, doesn't he?
Look, you, I've heard of things like this before. You've got me under some kind of spell. Well, I'm gonna break it. Now let me think. Bailey Park.
There is no Bailey Park. You weren't here to build it.
Mother? Harry? Where's Harry?
He fell through the ice, George. You weren't here to save him.
That's not true. Harry went to war. He won the Congressional Medal of Honor.
You weren't here to save him, George.
What happened to Mary, Clarence?
I'm not supposed to tell you, George.
Please, let me see her. Where is she?
You won't like it, George. She's an old maid.
What? Where is she?
She's just about to close up the library.
Is the library closed?
It's Christmas Eve. You can't stay open all night.
Mary, I'm sorry.
How do you know my name?
Please, just 2 minutes. It's all I need.
You sound troubled. If I can help, I will.
Isn't this town Bedford Falls?
It used to be, but then Potter was elected and renamed the town Pottersville.
Mary Hatch, you live in a white Victorian on Reed Street with your mother.
How do you know all this? Please go away.
Don't you know me? You must. Mary, it's George. Where are our kids? I need you, Mary.
Get away from me. Help!
It's George. Please, Mary. You're my wife. Help me, Clarence. Get me back. I need my wife and kids. This town. Everyone. Help me. Clarence, please. I have made a difference. I can keep making a difference. Please. Taxi drivers.
George, is that you?
Ernie, do you know me?
Well, of course I do.
I live here?
Well, of course you do.
Please, take me home. Happy holidays, Bedford Falls, and building and loan, and even you, Mr. Potter. Mr. Potter. Wow.
Thank you.
home.
Happy holidays, everyone.
George, I've got a little paper here.
I'll bet it's a warrant for my arrest. Isn't it wonderful? Hi, everyone.
Hi, Daddy.
Kids, Pete, Janie, Tommy, I can eat you up. Where's your mother?
She went looking for you with Uncle Billy.
George, darling, where have you been?
Mary, you're real. You have no idea what's happened.
You have no idea what's happened either. Come on, George, they're on their way.
Who's on their way? Police, FBI, let them in.
Now you stand right here by the tree and don't move. George, it's a miracle. Come in, Uncle Billy, everybody, in here.
Isn't it wonderful? Mary did it, George. She told a few people you were in trouble, and they scattered all over town collecting money. They didn't even ask any questions. Just said, if George is in trouble, you can count on me. You never saw anything like it.
Here you go, $242.
I made the rounds on my charge accounts. Happy holidays, George.
Right, everyone, a voicemail from London.
Oh, London.
It's Mrs. Gower. Told me you need cash. My office has been instructed to advance you up to $25,000. Hee-haw and happy holidays, Sam.
Harry!
Mary, looks like I got here too late.
Harry, how about your banquet in Washington?
I left as soon as I got Mary's message.
How about a toast?
Good idea. A toast. To my big brother, George. The richest man in town.
Look, Daddy, the teacher says that every time a bell rings, an angel gets its wings.
That's right. Way to go, Clarence.
Thank you.
rendition of It's a Wonderful Life. Please stay tuned for your program of popular holiday music. This is Delaney Harder signing off for WAPA in Wapakoneta and wishing you and your loved ones a happy holiday.